Princess Gloria. It is a great relief to see you safe and well.
I am sorry if I caused you any undue concern, Prince Castor.
Please, there is no need to apologize. If I might ask, what became of you after the fall of your kingdom?
It is rather a long story, I'm afraid.
And so, we find ourselves here today. You believe Savalon's current troubles to have been caused by the water crystal?
I do. And I wondered if your honored father might know anything that could help us in investigating the matter further.
Your Highness, permit me to offer my deepest sympathies for all that has befallen you. Alas, our own realm is currently suffering grave troubles of its own. It saddens me to say this, but we are unable to offer any assistance.
Silence. That is not your decision to make. You must forgive Dromed his presumption. While his official title is that of record keeper to the court, he also serves in an unofficial capacity as an advisor. And what he says is not without truth. Our current situation is not a pleasant one. My honored father, the king, his whereabouts are currently unknown.
Goodness! Have you any idea what might have happened to him?
Sadly not. We had thought that he might have been kidnapped, but we have received neither a ransom demand nor contact of any other kind. We have also tried to notify my younger brother, Pollux. But since setting off on his tour of the nations of the world, he remains unreachable. The Council of Elders has been satisfied thus far with our tales of sudden sickness, but it is only a matter of time before they begin asking questions.
I am ever so sorry. I pray with all my heart that he will be returned to you soon.
You are too kind, Princess Gloria. I will confer with the Council on the matter of the water crystal. Perhaps one of the Elders will know something.
That would be great, wouldn't it, Gloria?
You dare interject, servant! Have you no shame?
Oh, you misunderstand, Prince Castor. My friend here is no servant. He is a companion and trusted ally. I owe him my life.
Hmm? Friend? Companion? A lowly commoner?
Oh, come now, Your Highness. If you continue to insult my comrades, I fear I shall have no choice but to take offense.
Offense? At what? He is a commoner, is he not? I merely call a spade a spade.
Prince Castor.
Forgive me, Your Highness. I spoke out of turn. Now, to return to the matter at hand. Dromed!
The city's various districts began to fill with water at different times, but it seems the trouble first began around 3 years ago.
3 years? And was it not 3 years ago that Musa was attacked? The Council will be assembling shortly. We must consult with them on this matter right away. Please, if you would bear with us until then.
Of course, Your Highness.
Forgive the wait, Your Highness. Allow me to introduce Elders Cygnus and Bernard, Right Honorable Members of the Council.
Cygnus, Minister of Commerce at your service. A pleasure to make your acquaintance, Princess Gloria.
Bernard, Master of the Gaming Hall. It is an inestimable honor, Your Highness.
Prince Castor informs us that you seek knowledge of the water crystal.
We do indeed. I suspect that it might be the cause of the city having filled up with water. Might you know anything of such a connection?
Alas, the cause is somewhat more prosaic than that, Your Highness. I am afraid my men made a rather critical blunder while digging an underground waterway. In fact, you find us having just emerged from an emergency council meeting on that very subject.
And a very productive meeting it was, too. I must commend you on your ready acceptance of responsibility, Lord Bernard. To have offered to help in righting the mistake is further proof, if such were needed, of your unimpeachable character. This man is no crystal thief, Your Highness. You have my personal guarantee of that.
You honor me, Lady Cygnus.
Now, we must be getting on. The proposed countermeasures will require considerable planning if they are to go ahead. If you will excuse us.
Well, I guess what they're saying makes sense.
Perhaps. But if Bernard's waterways truly are the reason for the flooding, then there is one thing that strikes me as somewhat convenient. The gaming hall. his gaming hall, is one of the few places not afflicted, despite the vast quantities of water it uses.
Perhaps we had better go and take a look.
You will allow me to accompany you, I trust. If one of my subjects truly is connected to the disappearance of your kingdom's treasures, as a friend and ally, I cannot stand idly by.
Your help will be much appreciated, Your Highness.
And besides, I somewhat doubt the ability of this rabble to protect you. You are of noble birth, Lady Gloria. To associate so freely with the lowborn is...
Prince Castor.
Of course, Your Highness. Now is not the time to be casting aspersions on the quality of your companions. I hope you can all forgive me, and that I might prove to be of assistance.
I hope so too, Prince Castor.
All right. Looks like we're headed for the gaming hall.
Thank you.
Whoa. I never expected to see a fountain like that in the middle of the desert.
Me neither. Talk about decadent. Not that I mind a little luxury, but you can have too much of a good thing.
Oft. We spared no expense in decking this place out, that's for sure.
Prince Castor! To what do we owe this inestimable pleasure? Well, might I ask what brings you here, Your Highness?
Princess Gloria was taking a tour of the city. I thought it would be rude not to offer to accompany her.
Ah, the life of a prince is a hard one, is it not? But I am forgetting myself. Allow me to introduce Anihal. The rustic charms of her performing menagerie have been entertaining our clientele of late. You will have to forgive her abysmal manners. I found her wandering the wilds, and it seems her upbringing was far from civilized. But tell me, Princess Gloria, how goes the search for the water crystal?
We haven't found it yet, but we will. You can be sure of that.
Oh, I do admire your optimism, but I can't help feeling that you'll never find it, no matter how hard you search. What would it take to convince you that it was not in Savalon, I wonder? An official edict to that effect from the prince, perhaps?
I doubt it. Not that I don't trust His Highness, of course, but I would prefer to confirm it for myself. After all, thieves have a habit of hiding things rather well, don't you find?
Well then, far be it from me to hinder you in your search. But please, do take care. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Well, no offense to our new friend, but I can't help thinking he's got something to hide.
Bernard's story is certainly impressive. He built the gaming hall and earned himself a place on the Council of Elders, and all in the space of a few years. There were certain rumors, of course. But what newly made man is not dogged by the chatterings of the jealous?
All the more reason to suspect him, says I. There's no smoke without fire.
Maybe that minstrel can tell us something. Orpheus, was it?
Couldn't hurt to ask. Is there anything you can tell us about him first, Gloria?
Well, if I were being kind, I might describe him as committed to his craft. If I were feeling less generous, I'd say he was a raving egomaniac.
Remind me not to get on your bad side. But that's good to know. We might be able to use it to our advantage. Let's track him down and see, shall we?
It's him.
Orpheus, where are you going?
Whoa! Why are you trying to pin me down? I'm a seeker, man, a poet. I go where the muse takes me. Wherever the wind blows, whenever the spirit moves me, that's my destination, baby.
Uh-huh. So, where are you going?
Oh, I'm wasted on you, you know that. Anyway, I don't have to tell you anything. You're impossible. Fine. I'm off to the sand-swept ruins to bring a certain very special story to an end. Go on! Go running off to Bernard and tell him like I know you will.
Okay.
Jeez, I know better than anybody that a true artist needs dedicated fans, but why does Bernard keep the kid around? Loyalty's good and everything, but that kind of puppy dog stuff could really cramp a guy's style. Hmm? Well, look who it is. Ahem. Oh, she's the tragic princess of a long-lost land, and she cries a river while she stomps the sand. Will her crystal questing ever reach an end? Or will she die for duty here without a friend? Ooh, yeah. You gotta love the sad ones. That's a classic in the making and no mistake. Oh, hey, Princess Gloria, I didn't see you there. Listen, I've got a dash, but I'd love to talk to you sometime about what it feels like to lose an entire kingdom. It'd make one heck of a song.
He knew we were here.
He certainly did. And judging by his song, he knows something about the crystals, too.
Do you not get the feeling he's leading us a little by the nose?
So what if he is? No harm in playing along, right? Then, when we get the chance, we turn the tables and squeeze him for everything he knows.
Prince Castor, do you know the place he mentioned?
Yes. The ruins are to the south of the city. I will lead the way.